Amoeba, goats.
Odoman.
I mean.
And Lucy gave us like some punchlines. She gave us like that's those on that Sunday, because if we had to score it, Lucy had like 20 and Nege had like 2.
Yeah,
to me. Although I can't.
Welcome to F-Clip TV, your entertainment plug. Please like and subscribe and click the bell icon to get new videos updates.
Hey guys, thank you so much for joining us again. This is F-Clef TV, your entertainment plug. I am Logic.
And I'm Pritik.
Alright, in the house, you know, after each eviction show, there comes tension. Pressure on each of the housemates. I mean, one of them or maybe two actually left, and so it's like kind of dawned on them that yeah, this is a game. And then the fact that, you know, especially for those maybe that were up, like those that were part of the list for, they now realize that actually someone here went inside and mentioned my name. So this usually following eviction night comes fights. Special. Always trust Ebuka to shake tables. I mean, those questions he has the housemates every Sunday is like a table shaker.
Yeah, and I think this Sunday, Ebuka's comment was like what really started the fight. Because there are... Lucy was in the toilet and she was mumbling to herself that because of this girl, because of you, this girl's name always have to come up every Sunday. That was the comment Lucy made in the toilet that Nengi ate, and she was like, hope you're not referring to me. That's how Kasala bust.
And then maybe I should say that Nengi was already, I don't know, tensioned from the fact that Ebuka hacked that person, it was directed to her. Maybe it is a game, I don't know. And then she did not expect that maybe people will actually notice. And then Ebuka had, if she was playing the guys, if she was...
Yeah, that she wanted to eat her cake and have it.
Exactly. And where she denied, I mean, what would she say?
Of course.
And this whole Lucy matter happened and then there was outburst. Maybe Lucy did actually not plan for Nengi to hear.
Knowing the kind of person Lucy is, she knew Nengi was outside. And she said that intentionally, because she was like, because of you, this girl's name always have to come up every Sunday. So she was like indirectly or directly referring to Nengi.
And I don't know if she's trying to,
I'm not taking sides, I'm just saying what happened. I'm not taking anybody's side, I'm just saying how it went. Nengi was outside the toilet, Lucy was in the toilet, and she made a statement, because of you, this girl's name always has to come up every Sunday. She was referring to Dorothy, obviously.
And then why can't, I mean, Dorothy should be able to fight her battles herself. Why is it Lucy that has to mention?
Well, Lucy is like this big sister that she takes people's matter on her
she
head.
She wants to be the big sister. It's not like
so it was just sister. Like she was fighting for Dorothy, although she had her own personal feelings towards Nengi, but that fight was basically because of Dorothy. I mean, the girl was not complaining that her name comes up every Sunday, so I don't get why she had to like fight for her. But it's good to have someone like Nengi Lucy in your life, Sha.
I mean,
fighting your battles.
Yeah. And then there was exchange of words.
Yes.
Amoeba. Amoeba, goats.
Go do man.
I mean.
And Lucy gave us like some punchlines. She gave us like that's those on that Sunday, because if we had to score it, Lucy had like 20 and Nengi had like 2.
Yeah,
to me, although I kind of understand Nengi, she's not a confrontational person.
Yeah, maybe that's
unlike Lucy, so she could not really return the insult.
And then Lucy's voice normally is loud.
Yeah, loud.
Like very loud. And
another thing that vexed Lucy was, although we didn't see this, they were in the toilet when the argument started. When, okay, can you be the Nengi?
Why will I be the quiet one?
I'm Lucy in the toilet now. Because of you now, this girl's name always have to come up every Sunday.
Excuse me, sorry, are you talking about me?
If I'm talking to you, come on. That's how the fight started. And then also came into the toilet and he was holding. At that point, Nengi was the one talking, shouting. But when Ozo came into the toilet, he didn't go straight to Nengi, he went to Lucy. He went to hold Lucy back. And Lucy was like, I'm not the one shouting. Why do you have to hold me back? Go and hold her. She's on the legs being touched by me.
Like, Lucy made mention of the fact that she's always like wearing clothes.
Yeah. She has this pick me mentality. She's always exposing her body so that men can pick her. Blah, blah,
maybe
blah.
That's not Nengi's, I don't know, intentions for wearing those clothes.
I don't really know because, personally, these past few weeks, I see Nengi's dressing and I really don't like it because she's basically, there was one Sunday, the eviction, the first eviction
when Lilo and Katrina left.
The clothes she wore.
You remember when she was talking to Prince? That was, I don't know. And you had
and
to lie down.
Lucy also insulted Nengi based on her intelligence. She was like, I can do a PowerPoint presentation.
Bring your results.
You don't even know what that is. Bring your results, let me bring my own. And that, again, is something I don't agree on. You don't judge people based on their appearance. People see Nengi and they immediately assume that she's dumb. She's not bright because she's pretty. And that's not right, in my own opinion.
Well, I don't know. Was it like Lucy was judging Nengi based on the something?
Yeah, because on the launch show, when Ebuka called Nengi out on stage that first day, Nengi was like, she's used to people judging her based on how she looks, but she plans to show her intellectual side. Although we've seen little of that, but still, I don't get why.
Very, very competitive.
Yeah, that I admire about her. So I don't get why Lucy has to like insult her based on that, that she doesn't know what a PowerPoint presentation is. Although Lucy might be smarter than Nengi, but she didn't have to say that. That was too much.
I just feel like everybody was in the moment, like the emotions were flying here and there. So I would actually not hold them by what they said. I feel like everybody was angry and this is obviously an outburst. So maybe it's actually not right for everything they said. Maybe that's not what they like intended to say. And then, man, Nengi, yeah, she's posh, I mean, obviously,
yeah.
But she should have, I don't know, confronted Lucy more.
Well, like I said, she's not a confrontational person,
yeah.
So when she
was not really shouting, she was just raising her voice,
she was just,
too above,
but Lucy,
where she would normally talk. I mean, when Lucy is talking, it's like Nengi raising her voice, so.
Nengi and Lucy. We all know, in fact, even before this fight happened, we could have envisioned that if something was to happen between them, Lucy would obviously win because she's like the loud and insulting person. But Nengi, I didn't even see Nengi having like an issue with someone in Dallas because she's always on her own. She doesn't overstep her boundaries. And Lucy says something that every week, new week, new guy. That she's always jumping to a new guy.
These guys are coming to her now. Is it like she's the one that did the
that I sense jealousy. Because if you remember a time when Lucy was head of house and they lost their wager and she was crying in the
head of house lounge
and Prince was comforting her and she was saying something about when Nengi was head of house, everybody always listened to her, everybody was always running around her. So since that time I've sensed a kind of insecurity and jealousy and it really came out.
And then their Saturday night parties is never in Lucy's favor. I mean, she's probably always dancing alone. Yes, as in
her dresses are always not it. There was even a time she went to change her gown.
Yeah.
One gown they gave her, she had to go and change it. So since then, there's been some
and
kind
she's like
of
always dancing alone. Or like
all the guys
the
are
camera
always rocking, Nengi.
Nengi, Erica, the party rockers, the star girls, and she's like alone at the corner. So maybe I understand where she's actually coming from with the whole confrontation and everything. And then I feel like after Sunday, this whole confrontation with Lucy, from Nengi's angle, actually changed her a little bit.
Yeah, she has been kind of laid back and she has been covering up. more.
Yeah, with addresses. And on Monday, they had a game. No, when Big Brother gave them their wager stats for the week and they were discussing it, she was like sitting at the back. She was not talking. And Lucy was, you know, in a situation like this, you are in the house, you cannot avoid each other.
Yeah.
The person with the loudest voice wins.
Exactly.
She'll be the one here and there in the house, and the other one that is quiet will be. You have to labor for the other person. And Envy was unfortunately the one that had to labor.
I hope this does not affect her game though.
Exactly.
She does not shine anymore. Because when they were discussing the wager tax, I think on the normal the name could have been there. Discussing it with them, but the fact that Lucy was there taking the forefront, Lucy had to like
Nengi
had to relax and let her talk. So because of this, I'm seeing a kind of bad image to her game, because it will surely affect her game. And a lot of people have been complaining about Nengi these days because of the, and Lucy gained more fans.
Why
Nengi lost fans?
It was, first of all, a surprise that Lucy was not on the list 4. And like, even she's still in the house. Yeah, even this
list 8.
But well,
I feel like if Lucy had been evicted, this would not have happened. You see, people?
We still have Lucy, and then she gave us drama. And then there was a fight between Lucy and Erica later in the week, and Lucy was the opposite of what she was with
Nengi.
As in, I actually feel like maybe she didn't want it to be like she fought with two people in the ring, and then she was all shouting in both cases, so she decided to labor the second one. That was a good one. Anyways.
Well, after the fight happened on Sunday, they kind of resolved it, and Lucy apologized. Although Nengi did not apologize, but I think everything has died down.
What have you done? So apologies.
Yeah, apologies too like too late.
Yeah, you could have tried to control yourself when you were saying everything you were saying.
And not come out. That's like medicine after death.
Lucy was telling Nengi like, I'm 30, and like look.
This way, you are 22.
And it's only skin complexion you have. Like
yeah, she's saying I'm finer than you.
No, yeah, that's it. Like, yeah, just trying to. All right, thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you.
Stay tuned to FCLEP TV as we bring to you daily updates, happenings in the Big Brother Niger house, happenings outside the Big Brother Niger house, everything trending, everything hashtag. Yeah, stay tuned to FCLEP TV.
Don't forget to like this video
and subscribe.
Bye.
Bye.
Thank you for watching our videos. If you're not a subscriber yet, kindly click the subscribe button and ring the notification bell to get notified whenever we release a new video. Thank you.